You know, but
I
quite a few tricycles that way. And so we got back there, we climbed over the fence, and we were shooting around back there. And they come up to these tall plants, you know, and they start breaking off these things that look like celery and biting into it and just going, yeah, this is great. So I took and I broke off one of these celery things, and I bit into it, and it was the nastiest thing I ever tasted.
And
it was root water. Root water.
Gonna fall off again.
Push it on tight.
But we were England's, no colonials.
possessing what we were not yet possessed by what we now no more possess. Something we were withholding made us weak, until we found out that it was ourselves we were withholding from our land of living, and forthwith found salvation in surrender. The deed of gifts. Such as we were, we gave ourselves outright. The deed of gifts was new deed of war. So the land, vaguely realizing what was still in story, heartless, on his hands, such as she was, such as she would become.
There once was a beautiful princess, oh, ever so long ago, when the fairies, the kings, and all such things were calling me after them. Oh, but she was very unhappy, and if she ever smiled at all, it was once in a while a radiant smile when she heard of the fairies' song. For she had such terrible teachers, and lessons she could not bear. She hated to sew, and she hated, oh, she hated to comb her hair.
Well, you saw it,
though. One day she went a-walking to the forest in our back. The dark and dismal depths, yeah. Digging well, she stubbed her toe and fell down into the well. The well was all wet and slimy, and dark and muddy and deep. The frogs below the creepers or so would scrape the mud in the heat. And now our princess, then they clubbed together and a toast to call their name. And safe on that, the princess sat and waited for more to wait. Now a princess came arriving through the forest thereabout. And when he saw the poor maid sitting there, of course he helped her out. Of course they lived together till they reached the palace gate, where they alighted their narrow side and their wedding was held in state.
There's a polar bear in my refrigerator. He likes it because it's cold in there. With his seat in the meat and his face in the fish, and a big hairy paw in the butter dish. He's snivelling the noodles. He's eating the rice. He's slurping the sodas and licking the ice. It gives me a scare to know that he's in there, that polar bear in my frigidaire. As much as I know, it goes something like this. Once upon a time, there was a big group of men, and they were traveling in a wagon train westward. And they camped one night, and they pulled the wagon into a circle, and they all sat around the fire. And the one man said to the other man, well, be kind of nice if somebody would tell a story. So the second man said, okay, I'll tell a story. Once upon a time, there was a lot of men, and they were in the wagon train going westward. And one night, they pulled up into a circle, and they started a fire, and they were all sitting around the campfire. And the one man said to the other man, hey, you know what, it'd be kind of nice if somebody would tell a story. So the second man said, okay, I'll tell a story. And it goes something like this.
Thank you. mom and dad.
What is that?
Stand up, drop off. I know, but get on with it. Okay, so you and baby. What should we do? Should we take it home?
Why should we?
Say it loud, we'll get on with it right then. Is she sleeping?
I don't think I've ever seen any money from that.
Yeah, now it'll look beautiful.
Am I in? You know, you always get them when they're smiling. You never get them when they're crying.
Thank you. Stand back a long way.
Yes, true. That's all back there.
Okay, I gotta get Don's family.